A great tool you can use to configure a performance monitor tag is the Performance Monitor Tag Builder plugin under Points in the System Management Tools. The first tab, called Tag Settings, will simply ask you for some generic information for this plugin to know how to configure tags. Information such as the point source, interface ID, and the scan class to link the tag to a specific instance of the Performance Monitor interface, and then some more details to configure your tags. What's interesting here is that the plugin integrates with ICU, the Interface Configuration Utility. As you can see, there's a list from which you can choose a Performance Monitor interface. In some cases, if you did not configure any interface in ICU, you will see none, and then you'll have to configure point source, program instance ID number, and the scan class number manually. Otherwise, you'll have a great list of the interfaces you configured in ICU. So you just choose it, point source is automatically configured for you, same thing for the ID number, and then you get a nice list of the different scan classes you can use. The second tab is the really important one. It's the one where you choose counters and build them. As you can see, there's a hierarchy here. All the performance objects, Py NetFlow interface, Py Performance Monitor interface, they all provide counters. Under these objects, you have performance counters, and in some counters, you will have instances. So here we have the number of points configured in scan class 1 and scan class 2 in my Py Ping interface. You simply browse the hierarchy, you choose some by checking their checkboxes, they are pasted to the right-hand pane, and then you can simply create the tags. So this is it for configuration of performance monitor tags. This is the way where you choose counters. In some cases, you may have templates to use. If, for example, you have, let's say, 20 mail servers, you do choose counters for one, and then you can save this template and reuse it for the 19 other ones. Let's take a look at the next page. To use templates, everything is done via the right-click menu. In the right-click menu, when you click anywhere in the hierarchy, you get an option called Load Counter Template. A window will appear, a window in which you can choose a template that's already created. For example, a template you created for a SQL server or a mail server. Once a template is chosen, all the entries included in this template will be marked in red. As you can see, some of the counters are in red. You can then choose some more, and when you're done, you can right-click again, and then choose the option called Check All Template Entries. Let me show you in System Management Tools. So you can go Start Menu, Programs, Py System, Py System Management Tools. Under Points, Performance Monitor Tag Builder, then on the Build Tag tab, you see you could right-click anywhere in this area and click Load Counter Template. By default, we provide three templates, one for SQL servers, one for Py 3 machines, and one for a generic Windows XP 2000 or 2003 machine. Let's choose the Py 3 Diagnostics template. So now in the list, as you can see, there are some counters in red, some in black. See, some in red. These are the important counters we suggest people to monitor as part of our template. Then if you judge you need some more, you can simply check them. And when you're done, you right-click Check All Template Entries. This will result in checking all the entries that are marked in red. Then you can review your tags here, remove some, then add some more. And when you're really done, you simply click on Create Tags. This would result in creating 17 tags you can use in Process Book or in Data Link to see detailed information about your Pi server's operations. You may have noticed that it is possible to create templates. You could spend some time choosing the counters you really want to monitor on your mail servers. When you're done, you can right-click in the area, in the hierarchy area, and then create or edit counter template. Choosing that would allow you to create your template using all the entries you selected in the hierarchy. So you can reuse it then for your, let's say, 19 other mail servers. One last thing you have to know on the second tab before to click on Create Tags is that you can change the properties of all the selected counters. For example, you could click on one or more, right-click actually, and then click Properties. You would get in their properties, so you can change their descriptor, their span, their step attribute, and so on. Well, this was how to configure tags using our plugin. Now, here is what you would see in Excel if you import their configuration. The point type is any numerical type. By default, we normally use float 32. Their point source should correspond to what you chose in the interface. By default, the pound sign is the point source for the performance monitor interface. Then location 1, as usual, should correspond to the interface ID number as configured in ICU. Location 4 should be set to one of the scan classes as defined in the interface. The special field here is the extended descriptor, XDesk. This one is the attribute containing the path to the counter. An example of a path could be \\, the name of some machine, \, the performance object, and then when applicable, an instance, in parentheses, then \, and the name of the counter. In some cases, you may be interested in using the converse attribute, in which you simply put a number so the value is multiplied by this one prior to get archived. For example, you could convert bytes into kilobytes or megabytes. Here are some examples of tags you could configure to monitor Pi itself. For instance, you could look at the Pi base subsystem to get the number of points that are currently configured on your system. Or you could see the number of events that are archived per second, or snapshot events per second. Or get the time remaining to the next archive shift. You could even see how many connections are currently open on your server, or how many events are pending in your Update Manager subsystem. On this page, you can see two more examples of tags you can configure. Beside the point type, the point source, the location 1 and the location 4, what you have to look at here is the extended descriptor, XDesk. The difference in these two tags is that you have \\, the name of the server in the first one, while it's not there in the second one. When not using the \\ server, that tells the interface to look for local counters, counters on the machine where the interface is running. This is something possible, but not recommended. We normally suggest people to use the \\ server name notation, so it is more consistent. So now, if you have access to the regular IT Monitor class manual, you could go in exercise number 14, where you'll have a step-by-step solution on how to create tags to monitor your Pi system.